A bunch of the boys was whooping it up in the Malamute Saloon, that firewater shop where the trolley bus stops at 4 in the afternoon. There were desperate men in that foul smoky den, thieves and card sharps and murderers too. But the worst of the chaps that sat playing at craps was Dangerous Dan Fortescue. He was covered in hair like a grizzly bear and said, "Boys, I just don't give a damn." And there on his lap, in jodhpurs and cap, sat the lady that's known as Pam. Then out of the night that was 50 below, in the blizzard that beat, slashed and flayed, there stumbled a stranger. His flannels were creased, his blazer was dirty and frayed. No one knew where he came from, but I could read signs that an English Canadian can tell. I could see by his tie and the look in his eye, he was Harrow and Balliol and hell. For he looked close to death and swayed, gasping for breath, as the gale shut the door with a slam. No one else in the place saw the blush on the face of the lady that's known as Pam. I wondered and wept as I watched him and thought of the land whence he'd come, as my huskies outside, Fido, Geoffrey and Clyde, howled for their pedigree chum. The Arctic's no place for you, stranger, no cricket, no strawberries, no fun, and from Michaelmas clear through to Lady Day, never a glimpse of the sun. But his stiff upper lip, where the icicles dripped, meant his young face was shadowed with menace. In a queer, hollow tone, half shriek and half groan, he called out, "Anybody for tennis?" There was no sound at all. China ducks on the wall seem to sense when there's going to be trouble. Then Dangerous Dan, that great hulk of a man, slowly turned and growled, "Singles or doubles?" And the stranger replies, looking straight at Dan's eyes, "Why singles, old chap? You should know. For my last doubles pair was with that lady there, but you pinched her a long time ago." Then the half-breed took bets Dan would win in straight sets, for he serves like a battering ram. I climbed up there to the Schlesinger chair, and the chaps had a warm-up with Pam. 40 love game to Dan. Oh, bother the man. He's so strong and he's certain to win. Now it's match point to you, Mr. Dan Fortescue. But the stranger refused to give in. And the old trappers thought, what a jolly good sport to show pluck when he's in such a jam. He was beat, they'd no doubt. But they reckoned without the lady that's known as Pam. For she heaved a great sigh, and she slapped a huge thigh, muttered, "Dash it, it has to be done," walked straight up to Dan, towered over the man, and sloshed him a fourpenny one. One moment he stood, in his parka and hood, getting ready to smash on a lob. The next he was down, like a tree hits the ground when a lumberjack's out on the job. But Pam, mighty Pam, the bountiful Pam, leapt the net with a loud tally-ho and dashed up the court with vibrations that brought down some pine trees and showers of snow. And the stranger collapsed from her hearty back slaps as she thundered, "By Jove, you did well!" Her magnificent bust heaved with pity and lust. Gosh, she's a marvellous gal. Now the stranger and Pam are like baked beans and ham. A man never sees them apart. In fact, they're engaged. It was on the court page of the Saskatoon Tatler and Mart. They've been round to view a suburban igloo. 1930s, semi-detached. Mummy thinks he's quite nice now they've broken the ice. Daddy says they're perfectly matched. But Dan Fortescue hunts the wild caribou and camps by the old beaver dam. In the cold morning mist, he can still feel the fist of a lady whose maiden name's Pam.